with respect to talks with North Korea versus negotiations, and I think this seems to be something that people continue to struggle with the difference. My comments have been that the conditions are not right for negotiations. We've been saying for some time we're open to talks. President Trump has said for some time that he was open to talks and he would willingly meet with Kim Jong-un when conditions were right and the time was right. And I think in the president's judgment, that time has arrived now. So there's no, in my comments yesterday, I was indicating comments about negotiations, but we've been open for talks for some time. In terms of the decision to engage between President Trump and Kim Jong-un, that's a decision the president took himself. I spoke to him very early this morning about that decision, and we had a good conversation. This is something that he's had on his mind for quite some time, so it was not a surprise in any way, because I think this has long been something he's expressed it openly before about his willingness to meet with Kim Jong-un. So now I think it's a question of agreeing on the timing of that first meeting between the two of them and a location, and that will take some weeks before we get all that worked out. So no surprise. We know that there's been a lot of discussion, and you've been reading about it too, through the intra-Korean dialogue. We also have been having contacts back and forth with them, as you're well aware, through channels that we've had open for some time. And I think this was the most forward-leaning report that we've had in terms of Kim Jong-un's not just willingness, but his strong desire for talk. So I think it was really what changed was his posture in a fairly dramatic way that, in all honesty, became a little bit of a surprise to us as well, that he was so forward-leaning in his conversations with the delegation from South Korea.